For the first time, leaders from both sides of Australian politics have publicly called for Julian Assange to be released from a UK prison. The PM has also raised concerns about his well-being. The US wants to extradite the 51-year-old to face espionage charges over the publication of sensitive and classified documents.
Enough is enough. It needs to be worked through. We're working through diplomatic channels.
I think it's gone on for too long, and I think that's the fault of many people, including Mr Assange, to be honest.
Well, advisor to Julian Assange, Greg Barns, joins us now. Our political leaders have never joined forces in this way on the Assange matter. What's changed?
Well, I think what's changed is that there are many Australians who understand that this case has gone on long enough, that what the Prime Minister has been saying is right, that whatever Julian Assange might have done in the eyes of some people, he suffered enough. Certainly the development today in which we have Peter Dutton as opposition leader joining with Anthony Albanese sends a very clear message to Washington and I think is very promising in terms of being able to get resolution of this case.
For so long, though, supporters of Assange have said, look, he can't be extradited to the United States because he'll be executed. But now the Prime Minister seems to be saying, look, he's probably served his time. Doesn't that undercut the broader argument?
Well, not really. I mean, essentially what's being said is that he's served his time in terms of him being in the Ecuadorian embassy and then, of course, in Belmarsh prison, which is notoriously harsh for 4 years. I think what the Prime Minister's saying is that, certainly in Australian terms, he's well and truly served his time. And what, you know, where's the public interest in continuing to pursue the matter?
Well, the Prime Minister's also saying that he's working through the diplomatic channels to get him released. But how does that work when Assange still has to go before the court?
Well, because at the end of the day, this is a very political case. I mean, many extraditions are application of the law and no more. This is not. This is a case with a political overlay. And, of course, at the end of the day, it's not the courts that make the final decision. It's politicians. And so Anthony Albanese is absolutely right to be working diplomatic channels because that's the only way you're going to get resolution of this case.
Dutton blamed the hold-up on various people, including Assange himself. Do you think that he's been his own worst enemy?
Well, not at all. I mean, he's been pursuing appeals, and rightly so, because if he does go to the United States, he faces over 170 years in jail. He's entirely within his rights. And, of course, he did win the original decision. It was the US government which launched the first appeal.
The PM has also raised concerns about Assange's health. How is Julian doing?
Well, his health continues to decline, as his wife Stella says and his father, John Shipton, have said. And we've seen documented and court evidence in relation to the decline in his physical and mental health. And so at the end of the day, humanity needs to prevail and needs to be injected into these sorts of debates.
Do you think that Assange could still be a risk at all?
Well, I don't think he's a risk at all. I mean, as Bob Carr, the former foreign minister, said today, he's on trial for what? For revealing US war crimes committed in Iraq and in other theatres of war. He's never been a risk. His case is about press freedom. His case is about ensuring that Australians and Americans and others understand what it is that their governments get up to. And what he did in 2010 and 2011 was do the world a favour.
Greg, thanks very much for your time tonight.
Thank you, Hamish.